Does the owner of your company constantly take assets from and give assets to your business? Well, in that case, you should watch this video, Owner's Equity and Non-Cash Transactions. In other words, the owner brings and takes stuff. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. When the business owner takes from or brings to the business a non-cash asset, you must enter it as a journal entry. And the good news is, this is the most simple journal entry you will ever record. And it's two simple rules that you have to remember. Owner's capital investment is always credit when the owner gives an asset to the business. And owner's withdrawals is always debit when the owner takes from the business any asset, including a non-cash asset. Very simple to remember, even if you never studied accounting. Now, the assets in both of the two cases are valued differently. When giving assets to the business, the money amount recorded is the fair market value of the asset at the moment it is placed into service for the business. However, when taking assets from the business, the money amount recorded for the withdrawal is the purchase cost of what we, the business, paid for that asset in the first place. And once you get that money amount, you can very easily make the debit and the credit. For example, let's imagine on May 20, Vonda took home a piece of equipment that the company originally paid $200 to purchase. So that means what? It means equipment becomes this number. Well, wait a minute now, let's think about that. If we look at the reports and we go to the trial balance, we can see that before this transaction, equipment is $13,515. So if the owner is taking home $200 worth of equipment, and we learned a moment ago that when we withdraw assets, we record the money amount for the amount that was paid when we originally purchased it. So we're going to lower the equipment by $200, and if equipment now is $13,515, and we lower it by $200, it means after we record this take-home of equipment, equipment will become this number, $13,315, $200 less. And of course, the withdrawals become $700, because right now, Vonda's withdrawals is $500. But if she takes $200 more, if she withdraws $200 more from the business, that's $200 more in withdrawals, and this will become $700. Let's take a look at how to record the journal entry. We click New Transaction, go all the way over to Other, and click Journal Entry. Now, we know the date of this journal entry is May 20 of 2017. May 20. And we know from a moment ago that withdrawals, Vonda's withdrawals, is the account that we will debit. And that's in the equity area, Vonda's withdrawals. Because we learned a moment ago that we debit the withdrawals for the purchase cost of the asset that the owner is taking home. Now, what is the other account that changes? Well, if Vonda is taking equipment, then probably equipment will be a different money amount. And QuickBooks knows if withdrawals is debit, equipment is credit. And we know that equipment normally has a debit balance, and we're decreasing equipment because we're taking home $200 worth of equipment. After we click Save and Close, you can see that equipment became exactly the number we predicted, $13,315, and Vonda's withdrawals became $700. Now, let's take a look at this example. Let's imagine on May 21, Vonda gave a piece of equipment from her home, and at the moment she gave this equipment, we don't care what Vonda paid for it when she bought it. If she's giving it to the business, all we care about is this FMV, the fair market value of the equipment, exactly on May 21. Now, if she gives it to the business, equipment will go up. Well, equipment right now is $13,315. But if we have $300 more of equipment, it will become this number, $13,615. And of course, Vonda's capital will become $1,300, because before this transaction, Vonda's capital is right here, which is $1,000. So if she invests $300 more worth of assets, it will go up by $300 and become this number that we predict, $1,300. Very simple. We click the plus sign for a new transaction. We go over to journal entry. We put May 21, the date of the event. Now, we learned before that capital is always credit, the owner's capital, Vonda's capital, always credit at the moment that the owner gives an asset. And we go by the fair market value and keep pushing tab. And of course, if the asset that she gave was equipment, then equipment should go up. And QuickBooks knows if there's a $300 credit to balance this out, equipment should be debit. And equipment is normally on the debit side, so by making a debit, we will increase it like we're supposed to for $300. Click Save and Close, and now the trial balance has exactly the numbers we predicted. Equipment is $13,615. Looks good. And Vonda's capital is $1,300. And that's how you record, as a journal entry, a non-cash owner's equity transaction.